Casio B640WD-1A. I did my gold watch, I figured I'd do this one too. This is my daily watch. I actually like it better than the gold one, and I'll show you why right now. This is not a reintroduction of an old model. This is a new model. I believe it's module 3294, I think. Hold on. Yes, module 3294. If you want to know how to adjust the band, this is an adjustable clasp. If you want to know how to adjust it, that's in my last video, the one right before this one, showing my gold watch. It's really easy. Now up front, what sucks about this watch is only one thing, really. This is metal. This is metal. That's not what sucks. This is not metal. This is painted resin. Frost painted. But it's cheap, so you really can't complain. If it were metal, this would be a perfect digital watch. And you'll see why right now. Okay, anyway. So on the main face, on the timekeeping screen, you have... You can actually see if I tilt like this. There we go, you can see the lights. It's got two bulbs in it. This is actually plenty bright at night. Okay, anyway, starting from the top left, you have the what type of alarm notification is there, weekday, month, day, PM, if you're viewing in 12-hour time, or else I think it would say 24, hour, minute, second. There are four buttons, three of which are protruding, and one, the top left one, the adjust button, which is recessed. If we press that one, we start to adjust, starting with seconds, and then hour, then minute, then this changes from weekday to year. It shows 15 for 2015. This will go up to year 2099, I believe. Month, day, and that's it. Now if I press this, what the light button would be, it changes to 24-hour time. You can see 24H right there above hour. Otherwise it will show PM if you were in an evening hour. The last thing to show on this screen is if you press and hold the start-stop button. See the little eye thing up here above seconds? That's a very specific feature which I will describe later. Let's go to the next screen, which is the alarm. Okay, so we adjust that by pressing the adjust button, starting with the hour, and then on to the minute. And then you can do the date thing, and this kind of confuses people, but I will explain to you what that means. Ordinarily it shows four dashes, but it's meant to do month and day. Now if I have it the first digit to one, you can go up to 12. Let me see if I can get that in better view here. Can I do it like that? I think you can see it that time. Well, anyway, this goes up to 12 for 12 months of the year, and then back to a dash, and then back to one. Now if I have it on just with a month and not with a day, what that means is that for every day in January, that being because month one is January, for every day in January at 10:30 p.m., sound an alarm. That's what that means. If I go to the next part and I add in a day, so I now have January 1. This means on January the 1st, sound an alarm at 10:30 p.m. If I have nothing for the month, and I change that to a dash, this means on the 1st of every month, sound an alarm at 10:30 p.m. And that is what that means. You'll notice this number goes up to 31, because that's the most days you can have in a month. And then if you have it as all dashes, then that means sound an alarm at 10:30 p.m. today. That's what that means. And we press adjust again, and we are done. Okay, now the only other part is this top left. If it's nothing, like that's adjusted with the start-stop button. If it is Let's see here if I can get this in view right. Okay. If it's the little block symbol, that means alarm will sound. If I press it again, it turns to a bell. That means alarm is disabled, but sound a sound notification at the top of every hour, which is a double beep. That would be a beep beep. If I press it again, it means have alarm enabled and hourly chime. And I press it again, it's off. I usually have it set to just alarm for mine. When I pressed mode, it went back to the main timekeeping screen because this has an auto return feature. So, okay, so the next one here is the countdown timer, one of my favorite features of this watch. And it shows TR for timer. And the cool thing about it at the top right, that is the current time, which is cool. It won't tell you if it's AM or PM, but still, the fact you can view the timer and the current time at the same time is pretty nifty. So we adjust it by pressing the adjust button. We have our hour, minute, second. Now, you can set, have up to 24 hours of countdown time. 1, 2, 3, and then back to zero. It will do up to 23 hours, 59 minutes, and 59 seconds. Now, if you press the light button while it... Well, first of all, if you're not adjusting anything and you press this, it's just a light. If you are adjusting, where a digit is blinking and you press this, auto will go on and off. Now, what that means is repeat. So if I have this timer set to 5 minutes, I will actually change that. I'll go up to 59 and then back to zero. Now, to answer a question up front, is there a reverse digit direction on this? No, there's not. Forward only. So I'm just going to set this to 5 seconds. Okay, and I'm doing that for a reason. Okay, so now if I turn this alarm on after 5 seconds, it will repeat and keep repeating indefinitely until I go and I turn that automatic repeat off, and then we're done. And then the last feature is, and it had an auto return there, is the stopwatch. I don't know how long the stopwatch goes for, but I would assume at least 24 hours. And you can do can I do splits? Should be okay. There, yep, split. You can see split, SPL. Let me see if I can get that in view. Come on, focus. There it is. And then, there we go. And then reset. Okay, now, this thing, the eye. What is that? Okay, so on the main timekeeping screen, I turn on this. What this means is flash. If an alarm sounds or a countdown timer ends, not only will it beep, but it will also flash the display. So if I go to that countdown timer, okay, after 5 seconds, I'll put this, I'll lean it down so you can really see it happen. So I'll let that 5 second timer end and you'll see what happens when the flash is on, and you can see it because that little flash thing. Here we go. See that? Now, if I'm the flash can only be turned off and on from the main timekeeping screen, and you have to press and hold start stop to enable or disable it. You can always see it at the above the seconds, whether that little flash symbol there or not. So if I press and hold, it goes away. And then if I do another 5 seconds here, you will notice it will not flash now. It'll just beep. Should you use flash? You can if you want to. Oh, question answered. Can you have flash without the beep? No. And you cannot mute beeps on this watch either. So it's a slight limitation, but it's still, this is a fantastic timepiece. It's nice and light. I like it. It is physically larger than an F91, if you know what that is, but not too much larger. The frost-painted case is a bit of a deal-breaker for some. I still use this as my daily, though. This thing, it's got just the right amount of weight to it. Feels fantastic. Yeah, it's just, it's a good digital. So if you're looking for something different, basically if you ever wanted an A158 or an A168 with a countdown timer and an alarm and a chronograph, you wanted something with just like the F91, but with a lot more features to it, this is it. Thanks for watching. Take it easy.